Hello everyone, this is Rakesh Kapilis and I welcome you all in my today's class and I hope you all are fit and fine at your places. So as we know, we are on the way of doing the lesson trial balance and errors and the rectifications. So in our previous of the lecture, we have gone through what is trial balance and why we used to prepare the trial balance and what are the different types of aspects regarding trial balance. So now today, in our today's lecture, we will try to discuss the errors and their rectification. First of all, what is error? When in accountancy, any function, anything is being done without following the principles or by following the partial principles, then it is called error, right? Something which should not be done is being committed by the accountant is called errors. And when we talk about the errors, first of all, then we have to see what is its impact. Whether is its impact is in more than one aspect or in single aspect. So first of all, we will discuss what are the different types of errors. The very first error is error of omission. When you omit to record something, when you forget to record something, it is called error of omission. And it is of two types. One is partial omission and second is complete omission. Partial omission means when you record half aspect and half aspect you omitted. Like suppose an entry is there, purchase account debited to cash. You have recorded that in the cash ledger properly, but you have forgot to record that in purchase ledger. It is called partial omission. Second is error of commission. Error to commit something wrong. When you commit something wrong, when you do something wrong, it is called error of commission. That we will discuss later on. Just wait. Then error of principle. The error of principle is that error when you record something by ignoring the principles. Like for example, if we are purchasing an asset, then we should not debit the purchase. We should debit the asset, because purchase word is being used for the goods principle. Then second, you can take, if you are making the repair to your asset, then in spite of recording debiting the repair, you have debited the, what you can say, repair. Means sometime revenue expenditure is being treated as capital, and capital as a revenue is called principal error. Next and last is compensating error. This is that error in which the impact of first error is being neutralized by the commitment of another error. Once you have done first mistake, then later on you commit another mistake, and because of that the impact of first error is being eliminated, is being neutralized. That is compensating error. These are the types of error which you have to deal. The next is, what are the different types of error from impact point of view? So there are certain errors because of which the trial balance will not agree. And there may be certain errors because of which trial balance will agree. Means the errors which can be located by preparing the trial balance and which can not be located by preparing trial balance. These errors you can find by preparing the trial balance. You will prepare the trial balance and your trial balance will not agree. Then these may be the reasons. If trial balance agree, then as we have already discussed that it will only a proof of arithmetic accuracy. So trial balance is agree, still there may be these types of errors. That's why we used to say that the trial balance agreement is not the conclusive evidence of all types of accuracies. Okay, so when the trial balance is not agreeing, what may be the reasons? Number one, the wrong costing. This is error of commission. When you are committing something wrong, you are posting wrong, purchase account debited to cash, but in spite of recording in the cash, you have recorded in any other ledger, wrong posting. Or when you are posting the wrong amount in the right account. Account is right, but amount is wrong. Amount is right, but wrong amount, account is right. In that case, trial balance will not agree. Then wrong balancing. when we prepare any of the leather, then we have to make the balancing of that leather. If you have made any mistake in balancing, travel is not agreed. Wrong carry forwarding, the balance of previous year is being taken to the next year if you have committed any mistake. Like previous year's balance was 696, by mistake you have taken 969, then it will not be agreed, travelers will not agree. Last, the totaling, wrong totaling. Suppose you are making the total of the ledger and by mistake the total of ledger is being made wrong, then balancing will be wrong. When balancing will be wrong, then next year's opening balance will also be wrong. So because of these errors, trial balance will not agree. Come to those errors because of which trial balance will agree. The very first is error of principle. When you are committing such a mistake which numerical impact is okay, but logical impact is not okay. Like if you are purchasing an asset, in spite of debiting the asset, you have debited the purchase. So as you all know that purchase having a debit balance as well as asset having debit balance, so the impact will be on the right side, but the account will be wrong, but the trial balance will agree. Second, compensating error. As I have already told you, compensating error is that error in which first of all, accountant make first mistake, then with the commitment of another mistake, the impact of first error is eliminated, is over. The last is complete omission. Here I was discussing partial omission as well as complete omission. Partial omission is that situation in which you forget to record half aspect of anything. But in complete omission, if you have committed, if you have completely known anything like purchase account debited to sales, the purchase account debited to cash, you have not recorded in the purchase as well as you have not recorded in the another aspect, then the trial balance will agree. Why? Because you have ignored both these, you can say, aspects. So now we will discuss how you can find out the errors from the rectification point of view. Okay?